Hey everybody, how are you? Jeff Kelman, a solid canine training with my What Would Jeff Do Dog Training Tip of the Day. Tip number 180, leash reactivity. So I was out for a walk the other morning at about 6:30 in the morning with my pack. Joelle was with me with her pack. This was on our Instagram stories. If you're not on Instagram stories, you definitely want to jump on there. See a lot of great stuff. So all of a sudden we're walking by, we walk by this street, this little black dog, boom, massively leash reactive. The owner pulls the dog in, picks the dog up, and goes to the dog, "What are you doing? Those are dogs, they're just walking by." Now, I'm not gonna shame her, I'm not gonna blame her. She's doing the best she can. She just doesn't have the right information. She doesn't want that dog to be leash reactive. Absolutely not. She just doesn't know what to do. She just doesn't know what to do. That's how you teach leash reactivity. Leash reactivity is reinforced through love and affection. So many people out there are like, "No, somebody must have been mean to the dog. That's why it's leash reactive." You are 100% wrong. No, the dog is leash reactive because of love and affection. The dog lunged at the leash. She pulled it in, picked it up, and talked to it softly. She pretty much said, "You're doing a great job doing that." But it's not her fault. She didn't know because the information isn't out there enough. So, how do you stop leash reactivity? What she could have done, put a remote collar on that dog, put a leash and prong collar on that dog. It's all going to be punishment based. She's walking her dog. The dog freaks out at our dogs. She gives the dog gives the dog a very firm pop with a leash and prong. The dog goes, "Whoa, that sucked," and stops. Remote collar, stim, shock, call what you want. The dog goes, "Whoa, that sucks." And then the dog learns that that's a bad choice. And all these people out there are gonna say, "No, that's the worst thing to do." Bullshit. That's the proper, correct way to stop an unwanted behavior. "Oh, it'll make it worse." That dog had no equipment on, except for a leash and a collar, flat buckle collar or harness, I wasn't sure. It doesn't really matter. I'm not gonna bash those tools either. That's not what I do. And it was leash reactive. The crime was already committed. My advice is given after the crime is committed. I just fix problems, I don't create problems. None of my training has ever created a problem. The problem already exists. I show up after the fact and fix it. The reason why I'm specifying that very clearly is because all these folks out there are saying, "No, corrections and punishment and prong collars and remote collars make dogs whatever, aggressive, reactive." No, they don't. They absolutely do not. That's a lie. You are actually being lied to. The dog already is aggressive, leash reactive, jumping, pulling, nervous, anxious, fearful. Then we show up. We don't make the dog those things. Very important, because people are being brainwashed and lied to. You're actually being lied to by 90% of the dog training professionals out there, by your vet, by behaviorists. You can notice that a lot of my flavor of my videos now are very outspoken about this, because dogs are dying, dogs are being surrendered, owners are going through multiple trainers, and they're getting the wrong information. And it's so important. It's so important. Jeff Gelman, Solid Canine Training, madly in love with you. I'll talk to you soon.